Yes. So as I was saying about the story about once there was a young traveler who loved to travel to different parts of the world. He enjoyed experiences and adventure. And usually what happens is when he was traveling to all this location, he will pack his stuff, go on a backpack, and then he will start going on a journey. And in that journey, what he was experiencing, sometimes he will go through wilderness, he'll go through forests and so forth. So this particular day, this young traveler packed up all his stuff and ready to travel on a journey. Now, as he was traveling, he realized that the place as he's traveling, this forest is getting more and more dense. There are a lot of traffic. There's no traffic because it's a forest. But while in the forest, you see a lot of bushes, birds are chirping across, flying around. Sometimes you can even hear animals from a distance. So while this traveler was enjoying his journey into the forest, he realized that it's getting more and more lost. So he began to think, okay, maybe by lunchtime, if I can find the next particular person that can find down here, I will ask for direction, whether am I on the right track. So while he was looking at the surrounding, they're still not getting any result at all.
Okay.
So at the same time, okay. Sorry about that. Welcome back to... let me finish the story while I'm telling the rest. If not, we'll be half hanging.
Sure. Okay. Good morning.
Yep. So as I was saying about the young traveler, he was telling himself, the next person I can find, I will ask for the right direction. Whether am I on the right path? So he moved around. He couldn't find anyone. And he began to think, am I really on the right track? Am I really getting lost? So he started asking himself more and more. Then the forest become more and more dense, getting more and more tired. And as he was about to reach the point where he's feeling so tired and disappointed, where he's not able to find anyone, he began to think, maybe there will be someone around the corner this time. True and true, as he was turning the corner of the forest, at the pathway, he found an intersection. And in the intersection of the pathway, he saw an old man sitting there. So he went up to the old man and said, wow, finally, I got someone I can ask for direction. He went up to the old man. He asked, excuse me, sir, am I on the right track? And the old man, still sitting in the meditative pose without doing anything, began to continue meditating. And the young man once again asked, excuse me, sir, am I on the right track? And once again, the old man, still sitting in the meditative pose, refused to answer him. So the young traveler get very fed up, said, never mind, since he's not going to answer me, I'll just walk past him. So as he was walking past the old man, suddenly he hear a whisper. So the young traveler turned around and he saw this old man speaking. Very excited, he ran up back to the old man and said, what did you say again? So the old man opened up his eyes slowly and say, gather what you find before you cross the river. So young traveler think for a while, what do I need to gather? And he look around, he say, there's nothing here, well, there's no river still. Never mind, I'll just ignore it. Just walk past the old man. And once again, the old man go into his meditative pose, and the young traveler travel on his own. So as he was traveling through the forest once again, he came across a clearing, and then suddenly he hear sound of water. Feeling so excited, he rushed over, he saw it's actually a river across. Well, that's fascinating. So he went over to the water, splashed himself with water, feeling so refreshed, drink some water in his mouth and feeling so good. You can see sparkle of the water around, feeling so great. And as he thinks to himself, yeah, now it's time for me to cross the river. So as he was about to step into the river, he paused for a while. And think, what did the old man say again? He mentioned something earlier. gather what I find. What can I find here? Gather what I find before I cross the river. So I think for himself a while, say, okay, all I can see is rocks, sands, trees, leaves, rocks. That's about it. I must be crazy lah. Okay, never mind. So young Trevor put his hand down on the ground, pick up some pebbles, you know, small rocks, and then put it into his pocket. After putting it in his pocket, he began to walk across the river, continue on his journey. And this time, after he crossed the river, slowly the sun began to set. He said, okay, it's time for me to settle down, prepare his dinner, and he's ready to sleep. Now, as he was lying in his sleeping bag, about to sleep, he suddenly feel very uncomfortable. So, what is it that's so uncomfortable? Then he realized it's those particular pebble that's in his pocket. So, he went in, he realized that, this stupid man asked me to keep all these things for what? So, he took out the pebble, and as he was about to throw, suddenly he paused for a while. He looked at the pebble, and he went, no, it cannot be. For now, it is no longer rocks and pebbles, because in his hands, it's now rubies, diamonds, and gem. You see, the thing is basically that those pebbles were actually in his pocket with a lot of mud. As he crossed the river, the water began to loosen out the mud. As he goes into the sleeping bag, and he rolls around, he began to crack away all those muds. And then he realized, damn, I should gather what I find before I cross the river. So today we'll be sharing a lot of ideas and knowledge and information that can be beneficial to everyone. So gather what you find before you cross the river.
You know why I smile?
Why, Jiuqian?
Hopefully the gathering of pebbles won't be the trend after this. Everyone go and kill Jiu Tao.
Okay.
Yeah. 大家早上好，希望大家听得懂刚才 Nat 给大家说的这则故事了。有时候不要小看了一些看起来一点都不起眼的东西，或者是一些看起来可能不怎么样的很普通很平凡的东西。可是这些我们肉眼下看起来很平凡很普通的东西，可能它也是非常宝贵跟非常珍贵的。我觉得可能我们往往都会忽略了这一点。从 Nat 的故事了其实我不知道，我大概能够意会你要讲的是什么，可是我觉得它让我的联想是sometimes
imagination
we overlook。大家可以有自己的想法的 ，no right or wrong。From Nat 的这则故事，你联想到什么？我觉得这个是我们的一个最大的作用。我们可以有一个创意的空间。每天早上呢，可能给你说一则故事，你可以有自己的联想。对我来说，久见我感受到的是，在生活当中，有时候我们会常常忽略掉一些很简单。可是其实它可以是很美好的事情，人与事，我们都一直去追求一些比较复杂或者是看起来很不简单的东西。打个比方说，空气，你听到我说话吗？
Yep, I can hear you, but I'm trying to see what it is there. Okay. Everyone,
do we have any are we facing any technical issue now?
I see Ivy on the show that says,
yeah, she just came in. She said good morning. And then Grace also came in and Alice came in.
Yep.
Right? Okay, maybe it's time to check again. Is our viewers with us?
You want to pause on that, is it? Go ahead.
We'll kind of Vincent. We'll kind of Vincent.
Okay. All of them slowly coming in already. Back to 九件 about 空气。今天可以吃空气了。
不是啊，空气啊，就是其实空气它给我们的感觉就是它一直都是存在的。 他也，我觉得很多时候我们没有很认真的去看待这个空气的重要性，或者是我们拥有这一口气的那个它的珍贵。所以有时候我常常也会提醒我自己，哇，我今天一早上醒来，我有一大段日子哦，我是这样子提醒我自己来怎么样，就是感恩。也就是说好像我早上醒来我就会吸气嘛，因为你会发现我们在睡觉的时候我们没有办法感受到我们呼吸的，对不对？其实我们还是在呼吸，可是我们没有很深，我们没有很深的那个知觉，而是当我们醒来之后，然后我就会
呼气吸气，
哇，我还能够呼吸，然后就会觉得很感恩。
That's part of being grateful.
这个对我来说，它对它就是 it's a very simple thing, but we always neglect it. Now this is one thing, air. 还有我们周遭的这些自然生态 ，for example, the trees that I always like to mention, that I like to look at the trees, the grass, and just to describe a bit about my neighborhood, I see a lot of things. I see birds flying around on the trees, and then I see cats, you know, around, and there's people moving around. 其实这些我慢慢的我学会了，其实今天我们要讲的这个话题是 gratitude。
对，
其实你看，我一早醒来，我感觉到我的呼吸，还有我一走出我这个家门，我看到的这些东西，都有那么多能够足以让我感恩的，有感恩的那种感觉。其实我的心情变得很不一样。就像我现在，哇，我突然间讲的时候，我都会起鸡皮疙瘩，就是我能够跟 Net 在这边对话，还有我们现在也有一些朋友渐渐的上线来了，还有 Angela，Hello Angela， 还有雨薇，
雨薇，
对，还有一位新加坡的朋友，他可能现在也是待在新加坡吧 ，Terence，OK， 对 ，Terence Lai， 他是在上海。可是他现在应该是在新加坡，所以我们今天要跟大家讲的就是 gratitude 感恩。有什么事情会让你觉得感恩？
There are many things that can based on the concept of gratitude, and sometimes we are grateful for a lot of positive experience in our life. The key thing about being grateful and having gratitude also includesThe ultimate of being grateful and feeling gratitude about can also include things that can be challenges for you. For example, certain people...
要不要先说这一点？我先说这个。刚才 Nat 他是提到了 challenges can be gratitude as well. Can be
able to be grateful.
We should feel gratitude towards challenges.就是我们对于生活中或者是在人生道路上所面对的挑战，其实我们也要给予感恩之心。然后我们接着让 Nat 他再继续说这个说法。
So when you look at challenges in life, most of the time when we are experiencing challenges, especially, let's say maybe a fall, losing money in the stock market, having a health issue. Now, the thing is basically when you are able to look into the negative aspect and learn from it and embrace and be grateful for what you can learn from this experience, your sense of gratitude change. And that indirectly also helps you to become better. It's not easy because especially when the person is experiencing challenges in life, you will go to, why am I the victim? It's most of the time you go into the blame basis. But once you're able to accept and be grateful for the small little things that you have there, things will begin to change in the better light as well.
所以我觉得从今天开始啊，如果我们可能在过去的这段日子里面，我们因为人是善忘的。
Yes.
你认同吗？
They tend to forget, yeah.
we tend to forget, or we tend to be forgetful, or things become so common. 我们把它当成是理所当然。
Yep.
那你就会忘了。It's always there.
Yeah.
This is a word that I don't really like to use. 它不是，它绝对不是 compliment.
你的朋友啊，雨什么？忘记他们
雨薇
名字。他说 ：“Everything happens for a reason。
好与坏，我们都要学会感恩。所以雨薇他的、解释是说、不管是好的、坏的，就好像刚才Nat 他讲的 challenges， 有些人他们会对一些突发的状况，或者是人生碰到一些挑战，他会很抗拒，他把这个挑战看成是负面的。”哎呀，又一个挑战来了，就是他突然间会觉得很难去接受。当你也带着一种很负面的情绪去面对这个突如其来的挑战的时候，你会发现这个坎很难过，这个关很难过，你会让自己的变得很辛苦。可是如果你换一个想法的话，你转念哦，你把它往好处看的时候，我相信大家都会认同我的说法。你会发现这个挑战呢，它变得我的个人啊，它变得很好玩，很有趣。有没有自己的一个经验
？Well, there are many experiences that I've gone through as well. But if you look at, let's say, like what Michelle was saying on screen, A challenge can also be an opportunity.
对呀、啊，危机也可以是转机，大家应该都听说过吧？如何把危机变成是一个机会
？So when you look at the opportunity right now, for example, in the basis of the COVID-19 situation, it's a crisis, it's a challenge, but to some company, they are doing very well.Take for example, Zoom. Everyone uses Zoom right now, right? Yeah. So that can be an opportunity, even though to the general public, it's a challenge.
你知道吗？那天我在打包。我最近我常常其实我都是在家里煮。我尽量是不外出。可是那天我就突然间觉得，哎呀，就。我觉得这是蛮好玩的，有时候改变一下我的一个生活的一个习惯，对我来说是好玩的。我觉得啊，好吧，去打包吧。为什么呢？因为打包的时候你可以看到很多人
，correct，
然后我就可以听到很多人讲电话啦，然后他们跟人与人之间的沟通啦，那些对我来说都是很特别的一个画面跟经验。我就听到一个年轻人。他一边就是一边打包，一边他在电话里面讲，我最近我在帮这个 Amazon， 他们做这个设计的东西，
okay.
然后诸如此类的，对，他应该是在设计一些技术上的一个平台，
okay.
可能他们要在发展一个新的技术啊，还是什么等等的，然后他就说得很兴奋，他就说，哎呀，他应该是中国人啊。从他的语音，他说：“哎呀，我真的希望这个平台会成功。”他说的非常的兴奋，所以我觉得这个时候就像 Nat 他所刚才提到的，他在面对一个我们正在面对一个危机的时候，他很有可能他就会得到一个机会，他可能会看到转机。如果他的这一次的这个设计成功的话，
So sometimes in life,
okay, 你说 sometimes in life,
yeah, sometimes in life,
我这边我是要说，就是一些朋友他说还是要出门看看的，
对呀，
对 ，this is correct. 对我来说是的，因为要不然你就会变成像古人所说的，你一直在闭门造车。你会学到一些新的成语吗？那你知道是什么意思吗？
闭门造车、啊、
You close your door and you make your car inside. your house.
Oh, okay.
Inside the wow. Or inside the room.
Okay, you can never get the car out of the house.
你坐了这个车，你的门还是关上的，你的车也没有办法出去走啦。
Correct. Okay.
是， yeah, 所以他是说
that's a 成语 right?
Yes, it's a
成语的。Okay. That's one thing you need about Chinese languaging. You can phrase a four-letter word into a meaning and a lot of learning from there as well. Yep.
是，然后Pink Patricia 他也说 I agree as well. Yep. 他可能 agree 的是刚才我们说的把危机看成是转机，或者说 Patricia 也可能认同的是我们现在这个疫情的情况，当然没有特别的事情，不要常常出外，可是我觉得有时候出外去看一看走一走，那绝对是有必要的，也对自己是身心 是好的啊。我们现在可以先跟朋友就是说一下 Hi 吧哈，要不然就是冷，我们现在看到了有23位朋友，大家就是慢慢的进来了，很高兴今天能够看到大家。其实我们选择在早上的这段时间哈，我觉得它是一个挑战，因为大家会发现大家都在晚上做，可是我这边我为什么选择早上，因为我觉得一日之计在于晨，那你要学多一句，这个是谚语。
OK，
这个不是成语。
OK， 谚语啊。
你不觉得成语中国人？因为多个四个字的就是谚语。
OK，
四个字的就是成语。
成语，那俗语呢？来，
这个我就很俗咯。
OK。
我觉得 我不知道俗语可能是在民间里面传开来的一些俗话说、okay. 因为大家Michelle 你说笑得这么大声真的
他在背后笑嘛，没办法，他刚刚听到而已嘛。
我们都是所谓的俗人，俗人就是普通人嘛。
OK，
可是有时候 俗你也不可以乱用啊，因为俗不是 compliment 啊，你很俗啊，他可以这样讲啊。好，可是俗话说，其实我自己的这个解读是说，在民间里面 ，you know， in like the neighborhood， in the grassroots， you know the neighborhood area that people they use a kind of lingual， and then it starts to become popular。
Yes.
就俗话说的好啊什么的。
You saw what Keqing said.
Keqing said, 哈哈 Net have Chinese lesson, so we benefit too. 其实我觉得我们这个节目三人制哦 Power of Three, 我们真的是希望这个平台我们是互相学习的。
Yes.
我们今天谁都不会是比谁知道的多。可是当我们哦今天我们很愿意的我们都分享我们自己懂的，哇，那这个力量就会非常大，是吧？
对、
right. ，因为我肯定会有一些东西我不懂的啊。
That's the reason why every time when I invite people to come on our show, is to share their learnings. Because sometimes in their personal experience, we are you, I am me, but in our experience cannot cover all the thousands of people out there who have different type of experience.And in their basis of what they're experiencing, be it challenges or positive impact in life, they can also be a platform where they can share to the world.
是，那个 Jasmine 她说了，就是早上起来吃早餐，早上有精神。那再加一点，如果你是抱着带着感恩的心来用你的早餐，我相信那就更美好了。你看。我今天我早餐还没吃，可是我可以让你们看一下。My egg also have a smiley face.
哇 ，that's so cute.
我觉得这个是感恩嘛，就是我煎了两粒荷包蛋，然后我要 catch up 嘛，对不对？然后我就说，我可不可以让我的鸡蛋也有感恩的一个形象，然后让我的鸡蛋有微笑，我就用 catch up 制造了它的笑容。
I will only drink water with you.
And you should drink with gratitude as well. 我另外一个我想提到的就是水。我们常常都喝水。新加坡坦白说很容易得到水。大家认同吗？
Yeah.
Oh, no. 可是我不知道大家有没有在出国旅行的时候你们还看到人家拿着桶去提水。
Yep.
我看过，然后我甚至是到过一些部落，他们下雨的时候 ，when it's raining， 你知道他们第一个动作是什么吗？
嗯
，the first action when it rains。
Oh, they dance in the rain.
Okay, that's one thing, but that's a waste. That's a waste. Yeah, 他们立刻就是把家里的桶拿出来，然后去盛水。真的我看到，然后你就看到那些桶啊，就是那个雨下来的时候就滴滴嘟嘟滴滴嘟嘟，就是有那个声音嘛，对不对？然后这个时候我看到其实那个画面，他们在取水的时候，然后他们就看着那个雨水落到桶里面，他们就露出微笑，那个画面其实也非常的感人。
I remember years ago when I was doing journalism in IndonesiaLong time ago. So, when I was there,
in
在这个一个部落地区叫做 Gayo Agong, very far in, you only can find a well. So, when it rains, you collect as much water as possible. At the same time, when you shower, everything also have to be done through using the well water.
Have you shower with well water?
Yeah. It's very cool, especially in the morning.
对，我曾经试过，就是在那个西马的这个贫穷山区，然后他们真的在那个我们住的地方哦，其实就是他的那个所谓就是小孩子们读书的地方、上课的地方，然后他们有一个厨房跟这个浴室，他的浴室里面呢就有。一个人造的井了，人造的井，然后他们是把那个水呢放在那个人造的井里面，然后那些水呢其实都是从山上啊就是流下来的。
So they collect the water from the mountain down to the well.
Yeah, to the well. 是，然后我也在中国的时候呢，就看过一些古井，就是那种几百年的。古井，然后那个井的那个井口啊，很小的，大概，因为我们可能看过一些井是蛮大的，对不对？它那个古井啊，我这样的身材如果跳进去的话，可能就刚刚好了。比我再大一点的就不能进去，就会堵住那一口井，那个古井很小。他们也跟我说啊，他那口古井呢是曾经就是那边的村民他们用来就是提水的，是这个水供水的一个地方。
They supply water to the whole village, is it, or just only the few of them?
那个时候可、okay. 可是这个时候他们的那口井已经是没有用了。
Dry up already.
是。
Okay.
今天我们提到的其实就是要感恩。其实我知道我们有很多方法是能够有这种感恩的心的，对不对？那其实最近我看到一本书，它是跟快乐有关。它这本书里面其实它是提到了How to Find Happiness。那这边也可以跟大家分享的，它的关于如何找到快乐呢，其实有七个方式，可是今天我只提一个了。他说 happiness in life can be achieved through living in a way that promotes emotional well-being. Happiness is derived from within oneself and not from the outside. And research shows that happiness can be achieved when we invest in these ways of living. 那他刚好其中一点呢，他就提到我们今天的主题，那就是 experiencing positive moments and developing a sense of gratitude.
Yep.
It's one way that you will find happiness.
Correct. You know what Michelle said to Zhu Jian?
What did she say?
She look at the screen. Ha ha, I also want smiley egg.
Yeah.
I think way to show our gratitude for being alive is to smile and share our laughter. So being happiness.
So your next task, Michelle, is not the only. I already show you how to make a smiley egg. You know what you should do next? You should make a smiley egg. Yeah, you should make a smiley egg for your loved one. Besides kissing,
It is a smiley egg, not a smelly egg.
你知道什么是情人眼里出西施吗？
对对，那 that one I know.
懂吧？所以在就是你的情人哈，就算是 smelly 的话哈，他也是。
Beauty comes in the eyes of the beholder. So when you look at it, no matter how it is, they will always look good. So even if it's smelly egg, it will taste like beautiful eggs.
Yeah, it will taste. It will be a tasty egg, although it's smelly.
Yeah, you guess what Michelle said? Challenge accepted.
Challenge accepted. Okay. 这边要跟一些朋友就说早安。今天我们的主题呢是 having gratitude 啊。Hello, Annie, 早上好。钟明 ，Good morning！ 啊，当然 ，Jasmine， 非常谢谢你的分享，还有Kitchen 啦，因为刚才我们没怎么跟大家说早上好啊。Okay, back to topic。哎，我们要继续就是说一下这个 gratitude 吧。
So we have an in line in our list a few things that we want to talk about. We also have some quotes that we want to share as well. Let me just maybe.Quotes up, so at least we know what is it.
我们一起来看一些就是感恩物语啊。
Okay, so we start off with
感恩的字句。
Okay, I'll start with something simple. Then we go into English and Chinese as well. So
sure.
Look at this one. When eating bamboo sprouts, remember the man who planted them.So be grateful for the person who actually planted the bamboo sprouts as well. Because sometimes we spend a lot of time eating whatever that was there, but not knowing that there's actually a lot of hard work from people who build the plants, harvest the fruits for us to eat and so forth. So be grateful is one aspect as well.
对，所以其实这些都是很简单的道理啦。好像饮水思源，我们看到的这个 when eating bamboo sprouts, remember the man who planted them.所谓的饮水思源，其实这个说法也很广，好像如果那也是可以跟这个感恩有感恩之心就是连接起来的。好像打个比方说吧，现在我们常常会食物，对不对？我们每天三餐都要吃，那你是不是把你的盘中的食物都吃干净？就是好像这些米粒啊，我们从小就是家长都会教我们，就是说这个粒粒皆辛苦啊，对不对？都要把这些盘里面的这些食物呢都吃干净，不要有任何的这个浪费。其实也是饮水思源跟感恩的一个方式。
I agree to a certain degree on that basis, but there's also another saying from my side, especially for my patient, when it comes to weight loss. Okay, so when it comes to food, right?If it doesn't go to waste, waste, okay, you will end up in your waist. So sometimes we have to waste a little bit.
这个又让我想到了另外一个说法，那就是这个是因果啊。
Yeah, whatever it takes in, you expand out anyway. Yeah.
你种那个因就有那个果，那个果就是跑到你的腰围那边。
对了。You end up becoming your.
所以我觉得不要浪费的一个情况底下呢，就是不要太贪心了，对吗 ？You just take what you need.
Don't need to be too greedy, lah. Correct. Yeah.
是
And if you want to eat more, you can always come back again. So take whatever that is there, and then you won't put to waste, lah.
那这边 Alice 她说呢，观察周围的事物，感恩宇宙的美好。那也是有感恩之心。那这边跟 Carol 说 ，Hi Carol， 早上好。还有Agnes Koo，Good morning Agnes。Ivy 说 ，Absolutely right。
So let me just go to the next slide, yeah. Okay, the next one is by and this is, let me just hide the post. Okay, the enlightened thanks for what most people take for granted. As you begin to be grateful for what most people take for granted, that vibration of gratitude makes you more receptive. So it becomes a basis where you are able to be more receptive to positive change, to new things in life. Sometimes when you are so focused on the negativity and you forget about being grateful in life, what happens is all those options and possibility and opportunity, like we said earlier, just disappear. Because even though it's in front of you, you don't see it. So once you're able to be grateful, as this case is, being grateful, when you change your vibration, the opportunity, the options, and the good stuff that is available for you, in front of you. And then you have the clarity to be able to see it and then receive it.
对，因为我也很相信人的磁场。今天如果你是很正面的去看待人与事的话，很多时候你都会在吸收到一些正的能量，一些正面的事情它就会发生。那如果你一直都是以负面的一个情绪来面对事情的话，你会发现很多时候你的这个负面的情绪呢，它就好像滚雪球，它就不会停下来的。然后你碰到你，我不知道大家有没有这样的一个经验，你就会一直碰到负面的事情。
Yep.
负面的人啦、不好的事、不好的经验啦、不好的事情啦。可是你如果把自己好像刚才 Nat 他所说的，就是把自己换一下你的一个心态，我觉得其实拥有感恩的心态，其实也是一种心态。那我们大家其实知道自己是可以选择的，对不对？
You always have
负面跟正面。那你要选择负面，你可以选择负面了，可是你知道你选择负面的这个后果就是什么？第一个是什么？如果你选择负面去看待一件事情的话，我第一个会想到的就是，它会让你不开心。不开心，那为什么你要去选择它呢？
Like what Alice mentioned, I think it was Alice mentioned earlier.About everything happens for, is it or not? I think your friend Yu something was mentioning.
Yu Wei,
everything happens for a reason. So, in the situation when it comes to cases where it's negative, you get impactful about it. And once you continue to be in the same vibration, because people like people who are like themselves. So, once you are experiencing that state and you tend to attract people who will come into your life.For the purpose of the same challenge, and you'll feel even more lousy. By changing the vibration, by shifting the way that your mental thought is, even just simply lifting your body up, moving out from the space that you are in, you begin to see things differently. And once you're grateful for even for the small little challenges or small little impactful stuff that you can find from the big challenges, your vibration change. And indirectly, you also start affecting not only you,But the people around you. Because remember we mentioned before, people like people who are like themselves. And it's like flower can send fragrance out for when the pollen is out for the bees and the butterfly to come because it attracts them. In the same way, when you're having the same vibration of negativity, you will attract people who come to you in negative challenges.
所以有一句话叫什么呢？物来学一句成语啊。物
学成语。
类聚，
不以类聚。
我把它打下来，
okay,
我把它打在我们的 group 里面。
Okay, then I will post it up.
我打了之后，我再说什么意思？物以
okay
类，类呢就是人类的类啊。句
哦、oh, ，Okay, as in tears. Okay, let me
就像你刚才所说的，你会发现哦，一起在那边八卦的，说人是非的，或者是说搞破坏的。他们总是就是一群人呢
，OK，
他们就会吸引到这些很容易不满意的人，很容易就爱complain，
嗯
啊，然后可能说人家就很不容易满足，
嗯，
好、啊，很容易去搞是非啦，所谓的搞是非，你就会发现他们总是会吸引这些人。那可是如果你是正面的呢，他们也会吸引到他们的那一批，诶，他们都总是很积极，想法总是很健康很正面的，这个就是所谓的物以类聚。所以今天就看你要吸引哪一类。
嗯，
如果你自己是一个很负面的，你会发现你很多时候你也会吸引到一些很负面的人。那如果你今天呢，你就是很阳光，你就是很正面，很对人生的一种心态很积极，哦，你也会就是吸引到这些种类的人，他就叫物以类聚了。所以就像你需要讲的 ，negative
begets negativity.
Negative. It's very simple, actually.其实很简单的、yep. If you're positive, you will attract positive. And,、yep. and it's also when you think positive, you will attract positive results.
Yep.
If you keep on thinking negative, you will attract negative results.、
Mm-hmm.
So this morning, we are not telling you, oh, you should bePositive or you should be negative. I think the more important is what's your choice?、
Mm.
You make the choice because it's your life.
Correct.
It's not my life, you know. It's
your
life. Yeah, today we are just blah, 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 blah. Only. At the end, you are leading your life, not me leading your life. So even today we are trying to be positive, but at the end you want the truth to be negative, not to have gratitude.That's your life. Yeah.
It is, even when it comes to the basis of forming that gratitude. Last week, we talked about building a habit, correct?
Yep.
So when you look at habits, right, it takes about, I think there was a feature in the article by Psychology Today that says it takes about 60 days to just simply take a habit of eating an apple a day.
那他就说的就是我们需要60天来养成一个好习惯。
So even if you look at, let's say, creating the positivity of being grateful and gratitude about it, sometimes when a person is in the problem, it's challenging for them to just want to look at the positive side. So in some extent, we can look into maybe giving ourselves more.Basis of taking one step at a time to be grateful sure. for small little thing like maybe someone making you a cup of coffee today, okay, someone helping you with watering the plants out there. Small little thing, be grateful for all those little things. Then from there, as you begin to shift your vibration, your vibration begin to change, it becomes easier and easier for you to move towards that outcome.To immediately change from one to the other, 不容易啦 Because for them, it's there. Especially when they have a lot of negativity for the last 10, 15 years. To immediately say, okay, today I will be grateful for everything, it's a bit hard for them. So look into something simple, small. For example, like what Qiu Qian earlier mentioned about 下雨 Okay, be grateful for water. It's as simple as that. Be grateful for the air that we breathe. Be grateful to be alive.I had a friend recently just passed away. His name is, we call him Uncle James. It's quite interesting, and quite an interesting guy. He's very fun and witty. So at the age of 65, suddenly he just stroke. In 7 days, he just passed on. His body shut down. He cannot take it. So the family members who love him very much, he went into a relationship. And in that 18 months that they are together, they are grateful for every moment that they have. The love that he shared to the rest of the family members, the caring, the understanding, the happiness that they share. So sometimes be grateful for things that is gone. Because sometimes in front of us is there, you may just simply go missing. And one of the things is basically my late sister-in-law. For 20 over years, she was suffering from lupus, a sickness that actually eats into your immune system. And she's able to carry herself very well, always looking on the side of gratitude, positivity, pull herself through, become a piano teacher, walk around in cane, was on dialysis every week before she passed away. But in life, when she's always looking at the elements of living every single day with gratitude, even though no matter how much pain you're going through, especially those who experience kidney dialysis, right? It's very painful because you have the blood needle in your body, you have to go through cleansing. And all this time, she's able to look on the bright side every day, having laughter, being able to show love to the people around you. So sometimes in life, we can start with something small to bring about gratefulness.
所以如果说从今天开始哦，我们换一个心态，我们当然刚才 Netta 所提到的，我们可以如果在过去的这些日子里面，你都是一个比较负面的，那我们也不能够就是期望就是你立刻有，我们今天分享了之后你就有360度的一个大转变，那也不太可能啊，凡事都是需要时间。那我觉得你可以从小事开始，那是 Net 刚才说的，我们一小步一小步的，那你可以从今天开始，从生活当中呢，你去发掘，哎，有什么这些人和事，它是能够让你就是觉得自己有这份非常感恩的心。打个比方说，如果你用一个比较敏感 ，be more sensitive， and you look around， everyday life， be it。In the MRT, be it in a public area. 打个比方说，我是有搭这个公共交通工具的，我是搭巴士的。我觉得我很感恩，你知道吗？为什么？因为它让我有更多机会接近人群。我不知道那些就是驾车的人士，他们有时候会不会就是让自己有一个机会去走进人群，因为你发现就是驾车人士呢，他们常常就是自己在车里头，那可能比较少的时间会在人群里面。那我记得有一次我在这个巴士总站的时候，我就看到一位清洁工人。这位清洁工人呢，他其实他的身上呢，都他的所谓的身上，他是从头啊。任何一寸皮肤是在他的衣服外面的外头的，就是我们可以看到的，他都长着这个肉瘤，他的脸啊，他的颈项啦，还有手啦等等肉瘤。一般人看到这样子的一个画面的话，人家会觉得有点抗拒吧，对不对？因为在形象上面，我们可能会用这个美丑来定夺他，对吧？
The person with blood parts in the body
是，可是你知道他的一个动作哈，让我觉得他好美。我看到他在清洗那个巴士。他用那个水管，对，他在清洗那个巴士，然后他的动作、他的举止非常的认真，非常的小心翼翼的在清洗这个巴士的这个外观。外观。我等巴士那一天，我大概等了大概有十多分钟吧，他就一辆两辆就这样子清洗。他这样子一个非常细心而且 抱着一种热忱在工作的一个态度呢，完全我只看到他的那个内在的美，我完全就不介意他的，我完全没看到他的那个外在的那个，可能会让我们觉得哎呀，就是会有点抗拒的一种想法。我甚至我会想到就是说可能这个也是上天派来的天使，他让我有机会看到有这样子的人啊，他们还在非常努力的工作，哇，他让我觉得哎，我们真的是要懂得感恩跟好好的生活。
Sometimes in life, when we are too focused on the exterior, we forgot about the interior or what is there. And there are a lot of beauty in people around who has a lot of deep-rooted kindness that you don't see in them. They may look differently. Remember we talked about the eggs earlier, right? Sometimes when you look at the person who makes the egg, no matter how it looks like, the kindness, the love, the time I spend in making the egg itself and being appreciated and being grateful for it. That's what, like, an example of what you experience. Let me just show the next slides, so we can come back to that.
因为待会儿我们还有一些东西功课要教给大家的，对不对？今天在节目结束之前呢，这个 Nat 他有一套这个感恩的功课是可以让大家做的，所以大家先不要走开。那我们这个时候也刚好可以先跟大家说个早安，Good morning, it's a Sunday。那也希望大家能够把我们的这个视频，你会发现我们很少跟大家说 like and share， 因为我们比较专注在我们的内容啊。可是我希望我们这个三人制的 Power of Three， 大家如果觉得哎，它有一些内容是适合你的朋友的话，那可能你也可以帮我们就是分享出去，谢谢大家。
Thank you, everyone, and thanks, Grace, for telling me that you can't hear me because I just thought I was quite far away. Sorry about that. Okay, so yes, let's look at this slide right now. It says here, ultimately, the only way to experience richness of life is to live in an attitude of gratitude, to appreciate what you have and what you can give. And the best way to ensure your happiness is to assist others in experiencing theirs. This is a very famous speaker by the name of Anthony Robbins. He's featured in the Oprah Winfrey Show. He comes around globally to do conferences, usually about between 5,000 to 10,000 people will attend. So when you are able to help other people experience happiness in their life, indirectly, it also helps us to become better and more happy as well.
对，那从这句名言里面呢，他其实提到，如果我们要有一个非常丰盛、非常丰满的一个人生，其实拥有一种感恩的心态，那是非常重要的。那这个还不够，当我们懂得感恩，有了这份感恩之心之后呢，我们还要把这份感恩的心呢，也跟我们身边的人分享。那可能间接的帮助他们，引导他们，也让他们拥有这种感恩的心态，而不只是你自己独自拥有，那就足够了。我们还需要分享。那我觉得这个也就是点到了为什么这个三人制 Power of Three 的这个直播节目它的这个背后的意义。其实我们也是希望能够跟大家分享多一点这个正能量，希望大家，因为明天就是星期一了吧？星期一大家都说是 Monday Blues， 又要回到工作上面去啦，要为柴米油盐酱醋茶，奔波忙碌啦。那我想，在星期天这个休息的当儿，又要为新的一周做好准备的时候。我们是不是能够跟大家一起分享一些正面的一些方法，然后让大家慢慢的拥有越来越多，包括我们自己了哈。因为当我们在制作的过程当中呢，我们也是 起着一个提醒的作用，那我们就可以哇全副武装的为新的一周做好准备。
Okay, Michelle has something to say here as well. Because
sure,
when you are focusing on someone else's happiness, you forget about your own troubles. And when you experience your own happiness, unconsciously you become happy as well.
对，你就没有时间钻牛角尖了。
嗯、mm?
，对吧？今天我完全认同。你就会去多发掘人家的好。
嗯，
优点，而不是一直花很多的时间去放大别人的缺点。
Correct，
是吧
？Let me show you the other slide. Yeah. Okay, the final one, which is this one, in Chinese. You can see a horse.
塞翁失马，你要教我的哈。
I have to teach you Chinese. Okay, that's it, man. 塞翁失马 right? 焉知非福。
焉知
非
福
right?
啊，对对对，
嗯，
就是塞翁，其实他是这个故事这个人物啦，他里面叫塞翁啦，他失了这只马之后呢，你怎么知道他不是？也是一种福气呢，大家应该曾经听过这则故事吧？那这个老人他有一个，应该是一个儿子啦，大概是这样子。他因为骑马然后摔伤了，本来这个老人就说：“哎呀，就为什么这匹马就是让自己的儿子摔伤了这件事？”我不知道他们是不是要把这个马怎么处置这只马，因为这只马导致他的儿子受伤。可是后来呢，反而因为一件事情而让他要感谢这只马让他的孩子摔伤。那就是因为他孩子摔伤了之后呢，他不需要去到前线去上战场，去打战。而也就因为这样子，可能捡回了儿子的一条命。
So coming back to what Qiu Qian said earlier, so the story revolves around an old man who has a son who was riding a horse, and somehow or other the horse started running away and he fell off the horse and broke his leg. So in normal circumstances, when you look at it that way, the son is actually a victim of this situation. What is there to be grateful for? When you have a broken leg, you have a horse that ran away, you're losing money. But in turn of this horse losing, running away, and him breaking his leg, the next day, there was a calling for service. They have to bring this son to join the army and go to war. But because he has a broken leg, he's exempted from it. And then subsequently, of course, if you look at the gratitude behind how the father feels, looking at it in such a way that in this situation, even though he has broken leg, he doesn't need to go and see the army, don't need to go and join the army, and therefore he don't need to lose a son. And after a while, somehow or other, I think maybe the horse come back. I think so. So if you look at it as a whole, be grateful for even all the misfortune that you have, and then you can find what are the fortune that you will find from the misfortune. Because everything happens for a reason. And in time, sometimes when we begin to focus on someone else's happiness, you forget about your own troubles. See? So in that basis...
Hey, uh-huh.
Yep.
In the basis, yes?
Yeah, in the basis, when you begin to focus on the happiness even surrounding the people that can support you, when you help other people to be happy, indirectly, you are no longer focusing on your own challenges. And therefore, you are happy. So, like what? 雪莉 is it?
秀丽
是吗？秀丽 okay. A loss, no bad things or blessing in disguise, or a blessing in disguise. Yes.
是这个也是可以一个说法。也有时候，就是看你怎么去看这个福跟祸了。
嗯。
那有打个比方说，这一次我们的这个 COVID-19、嗯、你要把它看成是祸还是福、嗯、我觉得今天就要看你是用怎么样的一个心态来面对它、嗯、如果你是觉得哎，因为这个 crisis 哎，可是它反而让你跟你的家人多了很多亲子之间的关系，它是不是福呢？它让你在这一段阻断措施期间突然间学会了怎么上电脑，怎么用 Zoom， 怎么像我们现在在做这些，大家都成为自己的大厨，大家都开始做自己的这个直播网红、嗯、大家有更多的时间去做你要做的事，或者是过去不曾有时间做的事，那是祸还是福呢？其实那其实就是要看你怎么看待它。有时候我觉得它也让我想到，我们人在得与失的这个部分呢，就不要看得太重。嗯，那当你这个得到的跟失去的，你不会把它就是看得太重的时候，可能你就会又是另外一种得了。所以中文字我们讲舍得嘛，你知道舍得吗？你舍不舍得？你不舍怎么会有得呢？嗯
，OK，
舍其实就是 let go。嗯 ，if you don't let go， you won't gain something in return。
嗯嗯。So anyway, we
don't. We are actually over time, huh?
Yeah, we actually over time. But we'll come to.There's always a lot of topics that we can share on. So a little bit more before we close. We are always open to ideas and suggestions from any of the viewers. You can always write in to us, tell us what you want, and we can look into featuring the cover topic as well. And in the last idea, each week I will also be giving some tools as well. So last week we talked about breathing technique.This week we talk about gratitude. So a little idea that I always do at night before I sleep, okay, is to have what you call a gratitude book. You can buy this from Daiso, only costs about $2. And all I need to do is basically, you can write down a list of things that you can put online. Yeah. He also has one. Yep.
And I just pick it up from just right in front of me. You want to read this one? Can you read it?
I am not perfect, but part of me are.Pretty amazing. Yes, you are always amazing. Yeah. So the idea about this gratitude book is that you can write are you grateful for today. For example, I'm grateful to have my wife cook me a breakfast in the morning. Okay, what do I gain today? I gain new experience from people who share during our show. So usually what I'll do is just before I sleep, I'll write these two things on my gratitude book.What do I gain today? What did I? What am I grateful for today? And then as I look back, I've been writing gratitude book for the last 5 years. I have books stacked aside on each major book itself. So as you look at writing, I wrote a lot. So sometimes when you look back, you trace back of all those things that you write. You realize, hey, I didn't know that I actually experienced this before. It's quite amazing.And it becomes also
gained and
what am I grateful for today? What am I grateful for today? And what did I gain today? Mm. Yeah. Oh.
Grateful for today.
Yep.
So if you don't have a book, go get a book.
Yep. And I always advise if you can't write physically in a book, there's a reason behind it. Your subconscious mind, when you are connected through your physical hand when you write, it connects through your consciousness. So whatever that you write, it gets embedded in much better. Instead of writing on a text or just simply recording your voice, it is not as impactful. So as you write, you're actually what you call automatic writing. So this information that sinks into your subconscious better. And the best time to condition your mind is either before you sleep or just when you wake up. Because your conscious mind goes to rest, your unconscious mind becomes heightened. So at the point of time, whatever that you put in, that becomes the last thought in your mind before you sleep. So as you write down, you tell yourself every day, I'm grateful for this. What am I? What did I gain today? Can be a very simple thing. Even for example, walking on the street, I saw a 10 cent coin on the floor. I gained 10 cent today. Why not? Okay. So
我更希望你 pick up that 10 cent, 然后你把它捐出去。把它放到一些什么 community chest box, you know, McDonald's 有很多的这些。
Yeah.
对吧？那你又可以做了一个善事。Okay, so today the homework, gratitude homework will be get a book. 你看，其实这个是我的生日的时候，我的知音送给我的。Then you can get just a small one or even a much more half the size of this one. Okay, and start writing. Grace just said, we'll try. 你肯定可以做得到的。
It's a very simple process. Everyone can do it.
Yeah. And then start writing today. And if you don't want to start with two, you can always start with one.
Yep.
And you'll be surprised and you'll be amazed how this one or two every day will get you know, when you turn back the clock and then look at it.
Yep.
That's why I always still keep some of my letters and even some of my lyrics that I have written like on a paper or that for many, many years. And sometimes it feels good to just flip through.
Correct.
对啦，那今天呢，我们也到了11:41了，那也是到了节目要结束的时候了。非常开心的，今天就是第二期的三人制 Power of Three。今天比上个星期好一点。
Yeah, every week we come better and better. It's how we begin to expand, and more people will come in, and more people will share their personal experience as well. For those who missed my last, for most who missed my last week, I actually shared this.You can get a copy of my inner healing audio free. Just go to this website and just download it. And of course, like me on Facebook as well.
Yep.
Yeah.
要非常谢谢 Nat 哦，所以希望大家可以到 Nat 的这个 Facebook， 那就是 facebook.com/dasetti 去给我们的这位我的这个 co-host。我的搭档就是一个点赞，然后还有就是要这个音频哈，就是有助于你的一些内在的一些修行的话呢，你也可以去现在正在给你看的这个网站，那有这个免费的这个音频哦 ，audio， 让你从中可以去自己学习，好不好？
It's like similar to a form of guided visualization. So you just follow my voice guiding you through. So it's about 20 minutes or so. You will feel more at ease, more calm, and so forth.
And don't forget to always practice a simple breathing exercise that
we taught last week. Yes.
Shared with you last week. You know, the breathe in 4 counts, hold 4 counts, and breathe out 8 counts. Mm.And you can do it
4, 4, 8.
Yeah, 4, 4, 8. You can do it for 1 minute, 5 minutes. First thing you wake up, and then last thing when you go on bed to rest.
Yep.
好了，祝大家今天有一个非常愉快的星期天。
Thank you everyone for coming, and we will see you on next coming Sunday. Next coming Sunday, we are talking about what? Let me check.
Yeah.
Okay, let me see. Next week we should be talking about, let's see, today's gratitude. Oh, we can be talking about kindness. We can look at kindness. Yeah. How it can help more people. What is looking at encouraging people to practice kindness and state of being there.
好，那我们就下个星期。 下个星期一同样时间，下个星期天同样时间10:30和大家见面。
All right.
All right.
See you.
See you.
Bye bye, everyone.
Bye.